Ross, when you were trying to get into those writing rooms, when you were writing those script specs and those 9 years, how do you think that compared to your peers at that time? Were they going through the same struggles? Was it taking the same amount of time?
Yeah, for most of them, I mean, may not have literally taken 9 years, but one of my childhood friends is Joel Cernow, who created 24, co-created 24. And we were both aspiring writers. We had a radio show together, sketch comedy in college when we were freshmen or sophomores, I forget which. And then he transferred, went to UCLA, and we were both writing spec scripts in our early 20s. And he broke in the year before I did. He got his first staff writing job on a show called Bay City Blues, I think, which was produced by Stephen Bochco after Hill Street Blues. This was a baseball team show. And then the next year I got the Cosby Show myself. So, you know, we both became successful in our own fields, air comedy and drama, but it took us a while to break in. And I think for both of us, it took us a while to get good enough. It's really, you know, aspiring to be a writer and having the craft to be a writer, not just the talent, the basic talent, but the craft, takes a while. I remember before I broke through and got an agent, I was working as an assistant director, and a very kind television director knew that I wanted to be a writer and asked to read my spec feature film that I wrote. And he did, and he said, I want to give this to an agent. And he gave it to an agent, and they reported back the following conversation. The agent said, I'm not going to represent him. And the director said, well, why not? And the agent said, he's not ready. And the director said, I understand that, but isn't it obvious that he's going to be ready in a couple years? And the agent actually said, yeah. And when he's ready, I'll represent him. But I'm not in the business of 2 years from now. I'm in the business of today. And so that's one of the challenges for you as a writer, that just having potential isn't enough. You have to be ready to compete, so to speak, on a professional level. You won't be as good as you will 10 years into your professional writing career, but you have to be ready to hit the ball back and forth over the net with the people you're going to have to play with.
And what are some of the signs that someone's actually ready, that it's not just potential and not just, you know, blossoming talent?
Well, I think when you give your script to people who are in the business, and instead of sort of giving you general encouragement, they say something like, I want to give this to somebody, to an agent I know, or they say, what's the next step for you? I'm looking for an agent, I'm looking for a manager. Let me see if I can give this to some people. Because then that's validation. That's somebody who's a professional saying, I think this is professional level work. So I think that's a sign.